What's up, gamers? Today we are playing the 1997 DOS puzzle game Clone by Antares Productions. Let's get right into it. Nope. You see, it runs quite well under DOSBox, but you still have to use DOSBox like it's DOSBox. So my original experience with this game was way back in the day in middle school, probably not long after it came out, on one of those 1,000 free games shovelware CDs. And back then it was shareware, so you only got the first episode of the game, when in fact there's actually six, you see. So I've never played the other five, and today we're just gonna play the first one. Everything on the screen for people who don't feel bothered to read it themselves. Episode 1, Mornack's Castles. Once upon a time, on a very stormy night, a little blue hero was lost in a foreign dark country far away from his family. He decided to seek shelter in an old forgotten medieval castle to avoid the threatening storm that was about to break forth. As he enters the giant stronghold, the door is shut in his back with a chilly swirl of wind. As our little hero will learn later, the master of this secluded place is named Mornack. He's a powerful dark sorcerer who possesses all the castles of this realm, in which he is doing strange genetical experimentations. Hero here. Sometimes my DOS box will freeze up for a second. It's because my external hard drive is just going down. So there's three difficulty levels. They correlate to easy, medium, and hard. But for this run, we're gonna do it on cool, since I am kind of cool. Here we go. Controls in here are pretty simple. It's the arrow keys and the space bar. Use items or whatever. And as you see, when you use the arrow keys, all your dudes move at the same time. When you pick up items like scrolls or other items that you'll see in later levels, hit space to use them. Welcome. Welcome in my world of castles,
oh,
little blue
cool.
being. Hope you enjoy
Oh,
my
cool.
puzzles. Mornack.
Oh,
You
cool.
see, if you're stuck, press A to abort and retry the puzzle. To access it with keyboard reference, press F1 to pull your help. These are the keys.
Oh, cool.
I don't have a gamepad or joystick attached, but I'm sure it works just fine in DOSBox. And when you abort the level, all your dudes just kind of instantly die. You have to do this on a lot of levels, since it's really easy to get stuck when they're not designed well. Anyway. One of the big things with this game is that you have to make your little dudes get offset from each other correctly. Because there's no harm in bumping into a wall. You also have to make sure not to get your little dudes stuck so that they can't get to the gold crystal and show up in the wall. Perpendicular to arrows without a problem. It's been a hot minute since I played any of these levels, even though I know I've beaten this. So, it's not like I'm gonna be breezing through these levels or anything. So these traps are kind of obvious how they work, at least with the crossbows. But the acid cauldrons or whatever, they kill you if you go above them. And the lightning clouds kill you if you go below them. And then these other two guys, I think these other two guys just kill you if you get anywhere near them. Yeah. These things, you can't go between two that are facing each other. But if there's a lone one, it's not a problem. Protection. May these enchanted items help you go through this puzzle. Don't forget to activate them before facing the hazards. Press hold to cycle through your inventory. Press space to use current selected item. The Lonely Spirit.
Oh, cool.
So with this part, you have to use the moment of invincibility you get after getting hit, even if you don't die, to get past the acid pot. So there are some, like, you gotta go quick action-y parts to these puzzles, which is not always completely difficult. But it can be fun. These guys move literally completely randomly, so the only way to deal with them is to be very patient. So you can't push blocks against the arrows. The trick with this one, yes. So you get one of these into place, and normally, like, you can't do it, like, because if you try to push the green one now into place, it pushes the purple one off, like, necessarily, only one of them can be on at a time. The trick is, you use the one gate that opens to make an offset between your dudes, and then it's not so hard at all. Having to do this many, many times because it is possible to just completely fuck it up. Like I may have just done. No, we're good. We're good. We're getting there. Ooh, can I get out now? Whatever. Because you can push a ring with another ring, but only exactly one ring. Like I can't push. up level, but I feel like I got this. As he says, floating guardians, never dare look towards them. Their glare is of fire. Just look in the opposite direction and they won't stare at you. So this one, like, it's really interesting because you see your little dude, like, rolls around when you're moving. You can't get hurt if you're still in motion towards them, unfortunately. But I remember this level being especially hard on... Okay. You have enough health for one hit, and that's nice. And I remember this level being, like, really hard on the actually hard difficulty level. Or at least just taking a damn long time. Thank you. business at some point is going to be like, duh, you just do this and that. But I haven't figured it out yet with the blue one. I'm trying to remember where the purple one was right now. Oh, I see, I get it. Oh, almost got it. Yep, and it goes up. To the left, but not that far. That looks like a crappy thing to play for and see, but this is another one of those, the hard drive spun down, so it's... Ooh, this one's tricky too. It says simple, and it kind of is. What do you have to say? You thought, explosions can run through factory tiles, square into the area, so you're better forced into the air, so the fireworks would kick in, which is a cool name to have. In this case, you see, if I just blow up the bomb where it is, these lightning cloud things will get me when I try to go back in. I know the arrows on the ground are a hint, but I don't know what they're going to tell me to do. And I'm pretty sure that these are not just red herrings over here. But they might be. Like, how do you get those out? Get out of the way, fucking fuck. Nope, I lied. If you could push either one of these back towards the middle, it wouldn't be such a problem. Together for this one. Oh, jeez, there's wall switches I have to hit on the way. Let's split up, gang.
We'll be right back.
many. Too many indeed. Yes, I agree. I'm not stupid enough to just push that green block down without a dude down here to get it back in, out of the way. Same for this shit. I've already fucked up. Still, I get the concept. I just have to do it right. Like that. Make this difficult. looked easier when I hadn't done it yet.
Messed up again.
they want to come around up. They're going north. Excellent. Maybe this will work. This level, I'm gonna get back up to the menu, drop the difficulty down, and then try it again. Okay, so this is a lesson in pre-staging your counter pushers to...
Thank you.
Oh boy, I'm really in a pickle now. Solutions, or at least remember them. I'm close to the end too. I'm gonna finish this, even if I have to drop it down to easy for a few levels. I'll say it's much simpler. Really, it's the same puzzle. It really is the same puzzle. Spread out a little different. We'll be right back.
symmetrical in any way, I cannot get to the end. I'm crumbling right now.
What have I done here? Always come back and do the level whatever level branch I want to run. I'm Suspicious, our hero doubts being at his end with Mornack and stays on his guard. He heads home towards the mountains on the horizon from beyond which he came. End of episode 1. As far as I'm aware, you don't get anything special except cool points for beating it on the harder difficulties. So I know I kind of cheaped out for 5 of the last 6 levels, but for the most part I was beating this on medium. I think I'll do another video later with the other episodes. I'm not gonna subject anyone else to me suffering through the levels on a harder difficulty for probably hours.
there is a blurb when you quit that thanks you for buying the registered version or whatever. You were playing Clone. Starring Little Blue Bing, Sorcerer Mornack, and in appearing order, Dumbor, Slugger Guardians, Frantic Arachnids, Dragons of Confusion, The Walkers, and other stuff that are in the other episodes. The design, programming, graphics, and sound effects by Matthew Burnett. Music and sound effects by Wolf Bowers of Pigment Studios, which, as far as I'm aware, doesn't exist anymore. Thanks to all my family for their support, Wolf Bowers for having given Clemens such a great soundtrack. Blah, blah, blah. I'm getting some jitter on the music here, and I feel like that's because I've messed up my thought marks and narrations somehow. It's almost like a demo scene game where greens fly out at the end. Yeah, I didn't even beat the game, and it's giving greets to me, you know? I forget what the secret key is. There never was a sequel. It's actually kind of sad. Is it M? Is it K? Oh, yeah, it was one of those. Yep, that's our dude. Bless his heart. Thanks for watching. I would say like, comment, and subscribe if that mattered. But good night, everyone. Have a great time. There's a download link for this game in the comments below if you also want to play it. Okay, bye.